Thank you. got Andy Ingram on lead guitar. Behind me is Brian motherfucking Scott on drums. My name is Brendan. Thank you guys for hanging out with us tonight.
Touring. We couldn't help it. Concertaholic.
Nice, nice. What brought you to the Fozzy show today?
Because I've seen him before in Harrisburg, and I love coming to Baltimore shows, and I just wanted to come.
Nice, nice. Then a poor civilian dropped their phone. But also, what is your favorite song by Fozzy, if you don't mind? Have you listened to any of their work so far?
Yes, I listen to a lot of their songs, and I don't know, I can't name a lot of their songs. But I think all of their music is really good.
Nice, nice. Well, thank you for coming onto the YouTube channel, giving you your opinions. Is there anything you want to, like, sponsor, anything you want to, like, get out into the world?
Yes. Don't abuse animals.
Thank you.
Yes.
This experience is about to begin. We ask that you all please stand to your feet, tighten your leash, and come to the front. Do not be afraid. Good luck, and please enjoy the show. The 7-day slumber experience will commence in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Are you ready for the mighty Flossy? Well, you're stuck with us for a little bit longer, man, and I want to thank all the amazing staff here. They've taken such great care of us. Make sure you tip your bartenders. Don't be cheap tonight, you know what I'm saying? Also, big shout out to all the lighting and the stage people, everybody that seriously you don't see behind the scenes. This next song is a song that I wrote for my mother-in-law, and it's a positive one. And I got a diss track about her too, but let's talk about this one. No, I'm just kidding. My mother-in-law is an amazing woman. It's crazy, man. I've lived a tough life, man. I made a lot of mistakes in my life, and I'm, you know, ashamed to admit it, but you know, I've been locked up from Texas to California, and strung out on dope. And there was a time in my life where I didn't even feel like it was worth living. To tell you the truth, I even spent a couple of days here in your unsatisfactory facilities over here at the Rock. I gotta say, I've been locked up in a lot of different places, different jails and stuff like that, but Baltimore was by far the worst. I'm not gonna lie to you. If the glove don't fit, you must have quit. That's all I'm saying right now. I got off on that. Listen though, real talk, and I can joke about it now, but I've made a lot of mistakes, you know, and when you feel like there's no hope, this, and you got a lot of pain, man, you're almost willing to do anything to drown out that pain, and that was me. And so, but it's crazy though, because my mother-in-law, getting back to her, she was always somebody that never held me hostage by my past, you know what I mean? She was always somebody, yeah. And no matter how good you're doing in life, there's always that somebody, man, that knew you back when. They can't let it go of what you did, and they don't know, like, they don't see you for who you are now. They only see you for the mistakes you made, right? And my mother-in-law, though, is somebody that always saw me as a person, like I had value, and it meant a lot to me. And then she went through a very difficult time. And like after being married for 32 years, her husband walked away from her, and this was a dude that I saw as a father figure to me, because I grew up without a dad. And so anyway, he walked away from our family, and so my mother-in-law moved in with my wife and I, and I just wanted to encourage her, and the way that I get my feelings out is through music, you know what I'm saying? So I wrote this song for my mother-in-law, but it's a song that's helped a lot of people, and man, shout out to Jesus Christ for saving my life and giving me hope. Anyway, this song, Caroline, is an old school song, and so I'm not going to tell you how old it is. I don't want to give Ken's age away on the stage. But anyway, this is Caroline. Thank you.
bass, everybody. And this is my 21-year-old son, Blaze, on the drums, everybody. A part of everything I know. On your local rock station. This is Surviving the Wasteland.
Hanging out with Chad, we're here at a Fozzy Fuck concert. It's a good time, man.
So we were talking a little bit about Metallica. Tell me about your music taste.
My music taste is kind of a little bit of everything. It depends on what kind of mood I'm feeling. But Metallica is definitely a go-to.
What's your favorite Fozzy song? Is it Judas?
Yeah. Without a doubt.
It's a classic, man.
Without
it's
a classic. That's one of those ones that you hear it, you turn up the radio, drive a little faster, it's a good time.
Drive a little faster,
yeah.
Sing a little louder, you know, it's a pump song.
It's a good time.
Is this your first Fozzy concert?
Yes, this is my first Fozzy concert.
As well. I'm pretty sure they came like 2 or 3 times, haven't they?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Well, thank you for coming on to the show today.
Hey, man, it's definitely cool to be here with you. I appreciate you. You're a cool dude. It's nice meeting you. It's going to be a good time.
Thank you.
Baltimore, you are fucking amazing here tonight!
Why do you fight? Thank you.
battle for you, right? Listen, we want to thank you guys. Got a great rock and roll station in town, 98 Rock. We're very, very thankful that you have them here because they do a great job. They've really helped Fozzie. They really helped pack this fucking place on a Friday night. So thanks to them, and thanks to you all again here in Baltimore. But now we're here tonight, and I know I've got a question for you. It's a two-part. Since we played Baltimore so many times, how many people here have seen Fozzie play live before? Alright, here's the second part of the question. How many people here are seeing Fozzie for the very first time tonight? Or 10 months, or you're just hearing about us tonight for the first time. We appreciate you, and we thank you for joining us on Fozzie Friday here in Baltimore. This next song is an old school Fozzie song. If you know it, sing along. If you don't, just fake it. We'll never know the fucking difference. Yeah.
thank you, Necromancers, for coming out for another vlog. I had fun today. Got some really nice, good shots, pictures, and alcohol as well. Smoking a nice blunt and about to go home and get some sleep, baby. If you like this video, follow my Insta if you think I'm pretty, my Facebook if you like chip posts, and my Patreon and Twitter to help True Self Made Art succeed. Other than that, I now release you lost souls back to your regular schedule.